So we were solving this problem, problem number 4 in last class. It is a briefcase subjected to many forces as shown, and we were to find out its resultant at A and B. Do you remember this, Suraj?
Yes, sir.
And we also categorized this system of forces as coplanar but non-concurrent force system, because though the lines of actions of all the forces do lie in a single plane, their lines of actions do not intersect in a single point. Agreed?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Then what we said is, I have to replace all these forces by something at A which has equal effect as this system of forces on all points of the body. So, humne pehle kya kiya? What is the effect of 40 Newton force at A, 40 Newton as it is to be transferred? So, all the forces were as it is transferred at A. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
This plus moments caused by all the forces at A is going to be the replacement for this force system at A. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So now, right now, let us focus our concentration on how do I replace all these forces which I have shifted at A by a single force. Pehle wo karte. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
And how do we do that? For that, we have Rx equal to summation of x component of all forces. So that's what we are going to do first. What is the x component of 100 what is the unit? 100 Newton force. Tell me. Suraj.
X cos theta.
No. 100 Newton force ka angle kiske saath diya hai? Bolo. Is it with vertical or is it with horizontal?
Vertical.
So jiske beech mein theta, wo component cos theta. So its vertical component will be 100 cos 30. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
But its horizontal component will be 100 sin 30, and it will sin be towards 40. Right. It will be towards right. So it will be positive. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
So I am maintaining the color code. Jis color se maine force mark kiya hai, usi color se I am going to mark the component. So plus 100
sin
30. Happy?
Yes, sir.
What is the x component of this 20 kilonewton force? The force itself, because it is already in x direction. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
So I am going to call this as x and this as positive y. So therefore plus 20. Happy?
Yes, sir.
What is the x component of this 100 newton force?
Same 100.
Same, because it is directed in x direction.
X itself, direction.
And it is in positive x direction. Happy?
Yes, sir.
Now for this 40 Newton force, the slope of the line was given from which we had calculated this theta. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
So now, what is the x component of this 40 Newton force? Tell me. Will it be cos theta or sin theta?
Sin theta.
No. Aap theek tarah se main jo bol raha hu, apply nahi kar raha. जिसके बीच में थीटा वो कंपोनेंट कॉस थीटा. आर यू विद मी?
यस सर.
नाउ द थीटा इज बिटवीन व्हाट? थीटा इज बिटवीन 40 न्यूटन फोर्स एंड एक्स एक्सिस.
एक्स एक्सिस.
सो एक्स कंपोनेंट हैज टू बी कॉस. आर यू विद मी?
ओके सर.
अब केयरफुली अप्लाई करना. जिसके बीच में थीटा वो कंपोनेंट कॉस थीटा एंड द अदर कंपोनेंट इज साइन थीटा. हैप्पी?
यस सर.
And now this 40 cos theta, it will be directed towards left. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
So therefore, it is going to have negative sign. So I am going to write it as minus 40
sin
cos theta. Are you sin kyun bol rahe ho phir se? Is there a confusion, Suraj?
No, sir. It's all. Got it.
Jiske beech mein theta, wo component cos theta. So you have to do this. You do this and tell me how much is the sum. So 100 sin 30, I will do it with you.
Yes, sir.
So it is plus 131.68. And it is in Newton. So I will write the unit as Newton. This is Newton. Plus. And as it is plus, therefore it is directed towards right. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
This therefore sign is very important. Now what we are going to do, next step is we have to find out y component of all these forces. Happy?
Yes, sir.
And we are going to do its sum. So what is y component of 100 newton force? Tell me. Chalo, bolo.
100 cos 30.
Yes, jiske beech mein theta, wo component cos theta.
Cos theta.
So it is going to be 100 cos 30. And is it upward or downward?
Upward.
So positive. It is in positive y direction. So plus 100 cos 30.
Cos 30.
Happy? Does this 20 kilonewton have any component along y?
No.
Because it will be 20 cos 90. Cos 90 is 0.
0.
So yes, therefore, it doesn't have any component along y axis. Yeah. Similarly, this 100 doesn't have any component along y axis. This 40, however, has a component along y axis. And how much is that component? Tell me.
40 sine. 16.69.
Yes. Correct. And is it positive or negative?
It's negative.
Yes, because it is going to be acting downward. So therefore, 40 sine 16.69, but negative.
Negative.
So minus 40 sine of 16.69. Happy?
Yes, sir.
And how much is that? So let me work it with you. It is
75.11.
100 cos 30,
75.11.
Okay. Yes, that's right. And it is also positive, right?
Positive.
So therefore, it is plus 75.11 newton. And as it is positive, so what is our understanding? Therefore, it is along positive y direction, that is upward. Happy?
Yes, sir.
Now, how much, what will be the result? First of all, I converted all these forces into two forces along x and y directions respectively. Now I will convert them into one. How do I do that? R is equal to square root of Rx square plus Ry square. Happy?
Yes, sir.
So how much is that? Tell me. Square
root 151.74.
So how much? 151.59.
Yes, sir.
So it turns out to be 159.59 newton. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
And now Rx is towards right. So I have drawn this as Rx. Happy?
Yes, sir.
Ry is up. So I have drawn it as Ry. So R will be something like this. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
And what is its angle made with reference to x-axis? That angle we call it as alpha.
Alpha.
Is it me? And that, yes, alpha, sir, is tan inverse of Ry by Rx. So do that, tan inverse of Ry upon Rx.
29.70.
29.70.
70
degree. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
So have we calculated resultant? Yes. So what is R bar? Force resultant, I mean. Have we replaced all these forces by a single force?
Single force.
Yeah. And where should it act? We are now calculating the resultant at A. So it should act at A. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
So it is R bar at A.
A.
That's what I'm going to write. And that is equal to how much? Tell me.
159.59 newton.
59 newton. And this is not the complete answer. I have to show it in this fashion. It is in this quadrant. So I have to show this angle as alpha equal to 29.70.
Yes, sir.
This is the total answer. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
This is now only the force resultant that I need to apply, a single force that I need to apply at A. But along with this, I will have to also look at what is the moment that I should apply at A, so that that force and moment together will generate equal effect to this force system on all points of the body. Happy?
Yes, sir.
Moment ko bhul ke nahi chalega. What is the effect of this 40 newton force at A? It is 40 newton force as it is plus a moment. Happy?
Yes, sir.
हाँ तो वो मोमेंट आप कैलकुलेट करना पड़ेगा. बट बिफोर वी डू दैट आई वांट टू ब्रिंग योर अटेंशन एट अनदर पॉइंट. लेट अस से व्हेन वी हैव टू फाइंड आउट रिजल्टेंट एट बी, देयर आल्सो फर्स्ट वी विल ट्रांसफर ऑल द फोर्सेस एट बी. डू यू एग्री विद मी?
यस सर.
सो इज दिस फोर्स रिजल्टेंट गोइंग टू चेंज? नो. Whether it is at A, whether it is at B, or whether it is at any other point on the body, this resultant is not going to change. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
So can I write here as A and B? Have you understood the argument?
Yes, sir.
So whether it is A or whether it is B, first of all, I am going to transfer all the forces at that A or B, and therefore summation Rx is not going to change, summation Ry is not going to change. Why the hell would R change? So therefore, this force resultant is same at all points on the body. Happy?
Yes, sir.
Now we are talking about what is the moment resultant at A. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
And what is the moment resultant at B? Happy?
Yes, sir.
So ab kya karna padega? Dekho, to do this, I have to take moment of all these forces at A and add them algebraically with sign. If it is anti-clockwise, I am going to treat them as positive. If it is clockwise, I am going to treat them as negative. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
So what is our sign convention? Anti-clockwise moment is positive. Happy?
Positive.
Now, if I were to do this with this inclined forces, it is very difficult. Kyunki kya karna padega? Let us say I have to take moment of 40 Newton at A. So point A se 40 न्यूटन के लाइन ऑफ एक्शन पे परपेंडिकुलर ड्रॉप करना पड़ेगा, फिर ज्योमेट्री से वो परपेंडिकुलर डिस्टेंस निकालना पड़ेगा, एंड देन दैट डिस्टेंस मल्टीप्लाइड बाय 40 न्यूटन इज गोइंग टू गिव मी द मोमेंट ऑफ 40 न्यूटन. डू यू एग्री विद मी?
यस सर.
दैट इज टीडियस प्रोसेस. एज द इंक्लिनेशन ऑफ फोर्स चेंजेस, आई विल हैव टू यूज कॉम्प्लेक्स ज्योमेट्री टू फाइंड आउट द परपेंडिकुलर डिस्टेंस बिटवीन ए एंड दैट लाइन ऑफ एक्शन. हैप्पी?
यस सर.
सो इजियर वे इज वर्क विद द कंपोनेंट्स. You have already found out the components. So instead of taking moment of this 100 Newton force, I will take moment of its two components, one along X and one along Y. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
So therefore, instead of applying this 100 Newton here, I say that its X component is applied along X as shown by this black arrow. Are you able to see my cursor?
Yes, sir.
And I will say that a vertical component of 100 Newton acts at this point itself with this arrow. Happy?
Yes, sir.
हाँ, चलो. So अब उससे moment work करेंगे. So I am going to use the color code. So these two components I will denote by different colors. One minute. So 100 newtons vertical component I will show it by blue arrow, and horizontal component by black one. Similarly, this 20 Newton doesn't have any vertical component. This 100 Newton doesn't have any vertical component. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
This 40 Newton, however, will have two components. So, uska ek component I will show it in the green arrow. Another component I will show in red arrow. Happy?
Yes, sir.
This blue and black arrows, these are the components of 100 Newton. They are acting at this point itself, which is marked in black. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
And then this green and red, these are the components of 40 Newton force, which are acting at this point, which is marked in green. Happy?
Yes, sir.
Now, chalo, ek component ka ab moment le lete. Let us first work with vertical component of this 100 Newton force. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
So what is the vertical component of 100 Newton force? Tell me.
100 cos 30.
Cos 30. अब जरा यहाँ ध्यान दो, हम 100 cos 30 का मोमेंट लिखने वाले हैं. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
So here we are not bothered about whether the component is positive or negative. फोर्स का कंपोनेंट पॉजिटिव या निगेटिव है ये यहाँ पे कंसिडर नहीं करना है. उसके वजह से एक के यहाँ पे जो मोमेंट हुआ हो रहा है वो मोमेंट क्लॉकवाइज है या एंटी क्लॉकवाइज है, दैट इज व्हाट इज इंपॉर्टेंट. आर यू विद मी?
यस सर.
यू विल क्विकली अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट आई एम ट्राइंग टू से. दिस 100 cos 30 इट इज एक्टिंग इन अपवर्ड डिरेक्शन. डू यू एग्री विद मी?
यस सर.
व्हाट इज इट्स मोमेंट अबाउट ए? So if I drop perpendicular from A on vertical line, it is nothing but this distance, which is 350. Do you agree?
Yes, sir.
So when you are talking about vertical forces, you will be finding out horizontal distances to find out the moment. When you are talking about horizontal forces, you will be finding out the vertical distances.
Vertical.
Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
So what is the distance of line of action, perpendicular distance of line of action of this 100 cos 30 with reference to A? It is 350 mm. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
So 100 into 350, 100 cos 30 is the component multiplied by perpendicular distance from A, which
distance
is 350, is the moment. Now question is, what sign should I assign? It doesn't depend upon the sign of component. No. What you have to do is hold the body in your hands at A, in mind. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
तो इमेजिन करो कि बाकी के बॉडी के सारे सपोर्ट्स निकाल दिए, बाकी के सारे फोर्स निकाल दिए, सिर्फ 100 cos 30 ये ब्लू वाला एरो एग्जिस्टिंग है एंड यू आर होल्डिंग द बॉडी एट ए. तो एट ए किस तरीके का रोटेशन होगा, बोलो मुझे, क्लॉकवाइज होगा या एंटी क्लॉकवाइज होगा?
एट ए
एंटी क्लॉकवाइज, राइट? देखो, आई एम गोइंग टू ड्रॉ दैट रोटेशन हियर. नाउ इमेजिन दैट यू हैव होल्ड द बॉडी एट ए. आर यू विद मी? Due to this blue force, what kind of rotation does prevail at A? Dekho, anti-clockwise.
Anti-clockwise, sir.
Happy?
Yes, sir, got.
So,
yes, sir.
As it is anti-clockwise, therefore I am assigning the positive sign. Hell with the sign of component. Mujhe component ke sign se kuch nahi karna hai. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
Here I am writing down the equation in terms of moments. So, I will be concerned only about the sign of moment. This is very important. Happy?
Done, sir.
Done. Now, what about the horizontal component of 100? 100 sine 30. Do you agree?
Yes, sir.
Shown by this black arrow. What is the moment caused by 100 sine 30 at A?
Anticlockwise.
No, it is zero. You have to zero. Understand,
sorry,
that
sir.
Though I have drawn these forces here, they act at this point. So any force which has horizontal line of action at this point is going to pass through A. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
And we already said moment of a force about any point on its line of action is zero.
Zero.
Are you with me? So how do I write that? So I'm going to write it as plus 100 sine 30 into zero. Are
yes,
you with
sir.
Me? I hope
yes,
everyone has understood this point. Now, let us consider this 20 Newton force. What kind of moment does this 20 Newton force cause about A? Imagine that there are no other forces on the body. I am holding the body in hand at this point. This 20 Newton force, won't it cause anti-clockwise movement?
It will.
So therefore, you have to just imagine in mind that you are holding the body in your two fingers at A. This 20 Newton will try to rotate the body in anti-clockwise sense. So therefore, this component is going to be positive.
Positive.
Are you with me? I am not bothered about the sign of 20 Newton, whether it is positive or negative. Nahi. Don't worry about it. Consider only its magnitude. The sign will be given for the moment now. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
I am repeating myself, but this is absolutely necessary. So 20 multiplied by 200 is going to be the moment of 20 Newton force. Do you agree?
Yes, sir.
Chalo, ab aage chalte. What about this 100 Newton force?
Anti-clockwise.
There are no other forces and you are holding the body at point A. How does this 100 Newton force rotate this body about A?
Anti-clockwise.
Anti-clockwise. So therefore, I write plus sign. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
And what is its moment? 100 multiplied
100
by
300.
This distance, vertical distance. So that is 200 plus 100. That is 300. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
So 100 multiplied by 300. So far, so good. Now, let us look at this green horizontal component of 40 Newton force. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
What is the horizontal component? 40.
Cos 16.69.
Cos theta. But theta is 16.69.
69.
Are you with me? Now, I am not bothered about whether it is पॉजिटिव और नेगेटिव. कंपोनेंट के तरफ देखना ही नहीं है. फाइंड आउट, ये जो कंपोनेंट है इट इज टुवर्ड्स लेफ्ट, बट व्हाट काइंड ऑफ रोटेशन डज इट कॉज अबाउट ए? बोलो,
क्लॉकवाइज.
क्लॉकवाइज. सो दैट रोटेशन आई एम मार्किंग इट हियर. सो शुड इट बी ट्रीटेड एज नेगेटिव?
यस.
सो माइनस बोलो कितना,
40
हाँ 40
कॉस 16.69
कॉस
16.69
कॉस 16.69
इनटू
इनटू
300 सॉरी 200
200 बिकॉज इट इज एक्टिंग एट दिस पॉइंट एंड व्हेन इट इज हॉरिजॉन्टल कंपोनेंट वी विल बी कंसर्न्ड अबाउट हॉरिजॉन्टल डिस्टेंस बिटवीन ए वेयर वी हैव टू टेक द मोमेंट एंड दिस पॉइंट व्हाट इज वर्टिकल डिस्टेंस 200 आर यू विद मी
यस सर
so multiplied by 200 and now what about the y component of this 40 newton it is 40 sin 16.69 but it acts at this point itself do you agree
yes
so it will its line of action will pass through a happy
yes
so it won't cause any moment do you agree with me
yes sir
so ab zara dekho kaise likh raha hu I am not mentioning negative sign because this component is downward. नहीं, ये sign component का है ही नहीं. This sign is of nature of moment. Are you with me? So therefore, I am going to write it simply as 40 sine 16.69 into zero. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
Have we taken into account moments of all the forces at A? Yes. So what is this sum? Can you tell me? So let us do it together.
Fine.
So quickly I will resume the recording. So moment turns out to be 56,647.9 Newton mm. As it is positive, it has to be anti-clockwise. Now at A, if I were to replace all these forces by something which produces the same effect on all points of the body, I will have to do two things. I will have to apply force Ra equal to 159.59 Newton in first quadrant at an angle of 29.7 degree. Agreed?
Yes, sir.
Plus a moment of magnitude 56,647.9 Newton mm. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
In anti-clockwise sense. So I call it as moment at A. So what is the resultant of this force system at A? The resultant is not a single force resultant. It is force plus moment system.
Moment.
Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
Are you with me? It is also called as equivalent force system at A. And it is force couple system. It is a couple moment plus force. Happy?
Yes, sir.
Are you here? Now, except Suraj, I want everyone to switch off their microphone. Someone, Surojit Ghosh, please switch off your microphone. I get very irritated if you do not follow the instructions. Now, let us go ahead. We have to find out now resultant at B. Are you with me, Suraj?
Yes, sir.
Yes. So resultant at B अगर find out करना है, तो first part we have already done. This force resultant is not going to change. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
Force resultant remains the same, but what changes is moment resultant. So how do we now deal with that? So ये जो सारे forces मैंने यहाँ पे mark किया है, इन सारे सारों का moment आप कहाँ पे लेना है? B पे लेना है. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
Great. So if we have to take the moment at B, now I am going to use same color code, and I am going to show the signs of moment or senses of moments on this B side. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
So now let us consider the vertical component of 100, that is 100 cos 30. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
What kind of moment would this 100 cos 30 marked in blue will provide at B? So kya karna hai? You have to hold the body at B by B. Removing all other forces. So B pe hold karna hai and this blue force, what kind of moment does it cause about B? Tell me.
Clockwise.
Dekho, at A, the same component had caused anti-clockwise moment. Happy?
Yes, sir.
But at B, the same component is causing clockwise motion. So now the sign is for, not for the component, it is for the moment caused by the component. So I have to give the negative sign. Happy?
Yes, sir.
Mind you, 100 cos 30 is still positive, but I have to give negative sign because it causes clockwise rotation tendency at B. Happy?
Yes, sir.
So it is going to be 100 cos 30 multiplied by, what should I write?
Zero.
Distance of this line of action of force from B. How can it be zero? This line of action is vertical. So the distance is
350. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
When it is vertical component, we are worried about the horizontal distance. So multiplied by 350. Happy?
Yes, sir.
Chalo, ab aage chalte hain. What about its horizontal component? The horizontal component will still pass through B as well. A se jaise pass ho raha tha, waise B se bhi pass hoga. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
So therefore, I am going to borrow the same term here. Horizontal component produces zero moment at B as well. Happy?
Yes, sir.
Now, what is the moment of this 20 Newton force? Tell me, at B. Clockwise or anti-clockwise?
Anti-clockwise.
Yes. You have to hold the body at B and you have to imagine that 20 Newton is acting. So it is going to produce anti-clockwise moment. Happy?
Yes, sir.
So, and the magnitude is going to be 20 into 200.
200.
And it is horizontal force. We are worried about the vertical distance from B. So 20 into 200. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
Why did this component remain same in both the cases? Because perpendicular distance of this 20 kilonewtons line of action from A and B is same. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So now what about this 100 Newton force? What kind of moment does it cause about B?
Anti.
Pardon?
Anti-clockwise.
So therefore, this one. And 100 into 300. Are you 300. With me?
Yes, sir.
This component also remains the same. Now, what about this force, horizontal component? Now, look at this. This horizontal component is going to cause which kind of moment at B? Imagine the body is held at B and green force acts like this. So, what kind of moment does it cause? Clockwise. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
So what is the sign? Minus. What is the horizontal component? 40.
40 cos.
16.69. Multiplied by which distance should I be worried about? Vertical distance between B and this line. Are you with me? This point. So that is 200. Happy?
Yes, sir.
So even this component has remained same. Now, what about the vertical component of 14? At A, it caused zero moment, which is marked in red because its line of action passed through A. But is its line of action passing through B? No.
No.
Are you with me? So it is going to produce the moment about B now. And what kind of moment it will be? Tell me.
Anticlockwise.
It is going to produce
anticlockwise.
Now, unfortunately, this 20 Newton force and this force have been given in red. So please understand that why, as you refer to the lecture. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
So let us demarcate that so that there is no confusion. Just give me a minute. Okay. So now this red corresponds to this 20. So I will mark it in this color. Are you with me? Let me mark this 20 in this color. Happy?
Yes, sir.
And this is in that color. So now there is no confusion. And now this vertical component causes what kind of movement? Anti-clockwise. So should I treat it as positive or negative?
Positive.
And what will be the component? It is 40 sine.
16.69.
40 into sine 16.69. Happy?
Yes, sir.
Multiplied by which distance I should be worried about? Vertical force, so horizontal distance. What is the horizontal distance? 700.
700.
Between B and this point. So this multiplied by 700. Happy? Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
And its sign is positive because it causes anti-clockwise moment. Can you do this sum and tell me what is the moment?
Yes, sir.
I will do it with you.
An angle bracket.
Just a
find
minute.
The result.
Just a minute, Suraj. So I think I muted my microphone. I muted recording in between. So I will complete that. So we have found out that at point B, you have force resultant and moment resultant, MB equal to 4067.54 Newton mm. But this moment is different than moment at A. So what are the observations? If I go on changing the points on the body at C, I will have same force resultant, but different moment resultant. So therefore, for a coplanar but non-concurrent force system, at a point, you are going to have two resultants. One is force resultant, another is moment resultant. Now, if somehow we can find out points on the body where this moment resultant vanishes, then we will have only force resultant at that point. The next problem, we'll talk about that. That is also called as single force resultant. Chalo, ab ye statement padho. Yes, go ahead.
A couple of magnitude M is equals to 54 pound in and the three forces shown are applied to...
Wait. M is... pound inches. So here the force is in pound and length is in inch. The unit of couple moment will be always Newton mm or pound inches, whatever. Yeah, go ahead.
Pound inches and the three forces shown are applied to an angle bracket. A, find the result of this system of forces. B, locate the points where the line of action of the resultant intersects line AB and line BC. Sorry.
Right. तो अब जरा देखो यहाँ पे क्या पूछा है. फाइंड द रिजल्टेंट ऑफ दिस सिस्टम ऑफ फोर्सेस. क्या आपको ऐसे बोला है फाइंड आउट द रिजल्टेंट ऑफ ऑल दिस फोर्सेस एट पॉइंट बी, ऐसे बोला है क्या?
नहीं.
एट पॉइंट सी ऐसे बोला? कौन सा भी पॉइंट नहीं दिया है. डू यू एग्री विथ मी?
यस सर.
सो व्हेन इट इज आस्क्ड यू हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड दैट यू हैव टू फाइंड आउट द रिजल्टेंट ऑफ दिस सिस्टम एंड द लोकेशन ऑफ पॉइंट सच दैट एट दैट पॉइंट the moment to resultant should vanish. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
So find the resultant of this system of forces means when the point is not specified and the system of forces is coplanar but non-concurrent. Is it a coplanar force system?
Yes, sir, it is.
Is it a concurrent force system? No. Are you with me? So coplanar,
yes,
but non-concurrent. The moment you have a couple moment there, it is non-concurrent. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
Non-concurrent. Chalo. If I extend the line of action of this, if I extend the line of action of this, and if I extend the line of action of this, they are not going to meet in the same point. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
So for a coplanar and non-concurrent force system, if I do not specify the point where I want to find out the resultant, it means that I want to locate that point where moment resultant is zero and only force resultant prevails. Am I very clear?
Yes, sir.
So what I will do now is I will consider this point A as a origin. Konsa point origin consider karne wala ho? A.
A.
With this A as a origin and just give me a minute, or let us consider point C as a origin. You can consider any point, that is just a matter of choice. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
So let us go ahead with A. If I consider A as a origin, then and this is x-axis. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
And this is y-axis passing through A. Both are passing through A. Now, what I am going to say is, let D be a point where you have only force resultant. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
And what are the coordinates of this point D? They are x and y. I have to find out these coordinates, x and y. So at D, moment resultant is zero. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
So I assumed that at D, moment resultant is zero, and I have to find out this x and y. I assume that it lies somewhere here. Happy?
Yes, sir.
Are you with me? Chalo. So what is the first step? I am going to transfer all the forces at D first. So sare forces D pe transfer kiye. Ye sare wale. So unka resultant agar mujhe find out karna hai, so what is the first thing that I have to do? I have to calculate Rx and Ry. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
So let us do that. So to calculate Rx, I will have to do summation fx. So how do I do summation fx? Is moment ka kuch x component hoga. Moment and force are two different entities. So in summation fx, moment will not appear. You cannot add apples to oranges. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
Yes. So now this 10 pound force, it is acting in vertical direction. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
Will it have any component in x direction? No. Vertical forces do not have horizontal components. Are you with me?
Okay, okay. Yes, sir. Yes.
So 10 pound is not going to have any component in x direction. What about this 30 pound? What will be its component in x direction? Tell me.
30 cos 60.
Great. Positive or negative?
It will be positive.
Yes, very good. Because it is towards right. So
right,
it is going
yes.
to be plus 30 cos 60. Happy?
60. Yes, sir.
Great. Now, what about this 45 lb? It itself is in x direction, but in negative x direction. So can I write it as minus 45?
Yes, sir.
So can you tell me how much is this sum? Go ahead.
Minus 30.
Minus
30.
Just give me a second. Minus
30, 30.
Minus 30. And unit will be pounds because all the forces are given in pounds. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
And it is negative. Therefore, it is going to be towards left.
Left.
Happy? Great. Yes, chalo. Ab aage chalte hain. Here. Chalo. Suraj, is this noise from your side?
No, sir.
So others, please mute your microphones. Kitne bar kehna padega? Chalo. Summation FY. Yeah, tell me. What about the 10 pound force? What is its Y component? Tell me. Minus 10?
Minus 10.
Yes, great. Then what is the Y component of this 30 pound?
Minus 30 sine 60.
Why minus?
Sorry, plus, plus, positive.
Plus, it is going to be upward. So plus 30.
30 sine 60.
Sine 60, very good. And what about this 45 pounds? Horizontal sorry. Force. It cannot produce component in y direction.
Vertical, happy? Yes.
So yes. What is minus 10 plus 30 sine 60? Tell me.
It's 15.98.
Plus 15.98. Okay. So plus 15.98 pounds. Be careful about writing the units. As it is positive, therefore it is acting upwards. Happy?
Yes, sir.
Now what is R? We will complete this R and then we will stop for the day. So R is equal to square root of Rx square plus Ry square. Happy?
Yes, sir.
So tell me how much is that?
33.99.
33.99. pounds.
0 pounds.
Yes, are you with me? So it is almost 34. And what is the angle made by resultant with x-axis? पहले तो quadrant देखना है. So this resultant is in negative, rx is in negative x direction, ry is in positive y direction. Are you with me?
Second quadrant.
So rx and ry, so it lies in this quadrant. And what is its angle? So r is going to lie somewhere like this. Happy?
Yes, sir.
And what is its angle made with reference to x-axis? Tan inverse of? Bolo, kya liku? Ry upon
Rx. Ry by Rx.
And mind you, when you write that, you are not going to substitute the sign. Sign is already taken care of for deciding the quadrant. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
So 15.98 divided by 30.
28.04 degree. 28.04 degree.
So we have understood now the resultant is R bar is, we will take it as 34 pounds.
4 pounds.
And it is acting in the second quadrant with this angle as 28.04 degree. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so we will handle this problem. Remaining part of this problem is in tomorrow's class. Have you understood till this point everything?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, when you come to the tomorrow's class, I want you to go through this statement of problem number 6. And I want you to think on this. What is asked in the problem? I am going to ask you. Are you with me? Have you understood the concept or not? That's what I want to see. So read this statement and also, I want you to try and solve these problems H1 and H2. Homework problems 1 and 2. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
We will complete this problem and problem number 6 in tomorrow's class. So today, let us stop here. Have a good day.
Thank you, sir.
Kisi ko kuch doubt hai to yahan pe poocho. Otherwise, you can leave the meeting after putting your attendance.